He knows my name.
Yes.
When I call upon him, he answers me. He knows each tear that falls from our eyes. It's so soothing to know that the Lord knows us. Dear friends, we are in the 13th week in ordinary time. Let us approach the grace of God and pray. Hear our prayer, O Lord, this morning, as we place ourselves at your feet. For at your feet there is mercy. Lord, make our eyes open and our hearts burn within our hearts, within ourselves, as we, O God, reflect on the mission, on the call, on the vision that you have given to each and every one of us. May we count and understand what it means to be a follower, what it means to be, O Lord, a disciple. Help us, O God, to appreciate being an apostle. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that the worldly attachments of life may not prevent us from being true disciples of yours. Lord, hear our prayer. We offer you our individual intentions. Hear them, answer them according to your will. For we make our prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. Today is Monday of the 13th week in ordinary time. Remember the memorial of Saint Irenaeus, Bishop and Martyr. Our gospel this morning is from Matthew chapter 8, verse 18 to 22. I take the reading. When Jesus saw the crowds around him, he gave orders to cross to the other shore. A scribe approached and said to him, "Teacher, I will follow you wherever you go." Jesus answered him, "Foxes have dens and birds of the sky have nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to rest his head." Another of his disciples said to him, "Lord, let me go first and bury my father." But Jesus answered him, "Follow me and let the dead bury their dead." Beloved, the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Shall we observe just a moment of silence over the proclaimed word of God? Arise, Catholic faithful, rejoice and renew. Matthew chapter 8, verse 18 to 22. It cost to follow Jesus, but it cost more not to. It cost to follow Jesus, but it cost more not to. Therefore, the choice is yours. For many people, this is a test difficult to explain because it seems not to project, portray the kind of image, the Jesus image that we have of the Jesus who welcomes everybody. Everybody can come in so welcoming and everything. But here we see him almost throwing out two potentials who wanted to follow him. Dear friends, a while ago, if you remember, he warned us in our exercise of normal judgment to be careful to whom we give the pearls of the gospel. He talked about the dogs and he warned us about the swine. Now today, he even is so blunt and says to a scribe who follows him, foxes have dens and birds of the sky have nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to lay down his head. Jesus is supposed to only be a loving and accepting person. So a lot of people claim. So Jesus, we find here in today's reading, easily irritated human, not the Son of God, so to speak. For some of us, is this God? Is this the Jesus I know? He should be welcoming everybody. Of course, he is welcoming everybody, but at a cost. Now we could really call it quits here, since what I just said seems sufficient to explain this passage. What am I saying here? That he's so blunt. He does not mince a word. He just tells us that, be careful. What is Jesus saying here? Let us hear him. Now, Jesus saw a crowd around him. He gave orders to go over to the other side, okay? Some person come to him and says, teacher, I will follow you wherever you go. And Jesus says to him, foxes have holes and the birds of the air have nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head. This was the first person. To the second person who came to him and says, Lord, let me first go and bury my father. Jesus said to him, follow me and leave the dead to bury their dead. Wow. So here we have two would-be disciples whom Jesus seems to be just brushed off at least, or treat them not so politely. But was he really just being thuggish, a bully, or uncaring? Was Jesus being uncaring with his words? Wasn't Jesus a little bit harsh? I'm sure on Saturday we'll have opportunity to really look at this. But for now, keep thinking about it. And if you are thinking about it, then you ask yourself, if I am to go out into the world, how am I to behave? Am I to be accepting anything at all just because I want numbers? Certain people have made Christianity a religion such that it accepts anything, because what is important is that we have the numbers. It seems his reply makes it clear that he is simply emphasizing something he often said. Becoming a disciple will not be a picnic. Will not be a picnic. In fact, when you go to church on Sunday, we go to fellowship, meaning that we are fellows on a ship. And there are two kinds of ship here. There is the ship that you sit on as a cruise ship, where you go, where people serve you. You when you are on a cruise ship, you pay your money, they take care of you, you go for meals, you don't do anything. In fact, you are there for pleasure. For many of us, Christianity is a cruise ship, because we are fellows on a ship. And for us, yes, I have paid, so I need to be served. But dear friends, no. Christianity is rather a worship. A worship is where everybody is there. It's like you understand, worship, a worship. A worship, like a warship, will give us worship, where we are able, everybody on a ship, everybody is a potential servant. And until we are back from sea, we are always ready for the next battle. To be a soldier is not about your dressing. It's not about your titles. It's about your ability to go to war and come back home safely. Dear friends, are you on a warship or you are on a cruise ship for your fellowship? It should cost a person everything, and it will mean they will become hated by the world, just as the world hated him. If people do not hate you for being a Christian, then you have not started challenging them yet. Indeed, just as the chapters later would treat to us, that very soon Christianity brings persecution. Christianity brings persecution. It challenges the status quo. It challenges moral standards. The kind of Christianity today that we practice, that is so, you know, it's so lackadaisical. Accepting everything must be looked at again. Given the very real danger facing the disciples, including death, in Matthew chapter 10, verse 21, we can actually thank Jesus for making things difficult for potential disciples. Because when we become disciples, we are ready to die. We are ready to die. Many other Christians today who will not take anything about death. If I say today I am going to die, or we are going to die, everybody will say, why do you speak like that? Why do you mention things like that? And yet, that is the reason why we came. That's the reason why we are born. It's about death. But death in the Lord. They that die in the Lord are those who have hope in the future. Because Jesus expands the scribes' concept of following by referring to the discipleship in terms of a kind of urgent wandering and a homeless ministry, his answer may well have surprised the scribe. Jesus means that life for him and the disciple who do follow him will be a matter of rigorous and self-denying living. Every day, we must deny ourselves, take up our cross, and follow him. This is the instruction of Jesus to us. Concerning the second potential recruit, there might appear to be more reason here to be concerned about the supposed harshness of Jesus. After all, in the Jewish culture of the day and day, family loyalty was important, and things like burial seemed so important and everything, just like typical us Africans and Ghanaians. If it is a funeral, you can even go and get a loan just for a burial. Meanwhile, the living will be suffering. Jesus will again insist on the radical requirement of discipleship. This is what he challenges us. Dear friends, in both cases, these men were not in the proper place to seek to follow Jesus. What about you? If the first was over-eager, the second was under-eager, the first promises too much what he cannot deliver, while the second promises too little what he does not want to sacrifice. What is your position? What is your position? Are you giving more than you should give? Are you speaking just anything anyhow? Or are you being mean? Are you being mean with the talent that God has given you? What is your position? God richly bless you. Amen.